Meanwhile, how is it that a small wooden object that harmonizes musical languages of all corners of the world? How is it possible? Well, Daniel Hoffman found out because he traveled to Ireland and made a documentary called Otherwise It's Just Firewood. We're very happy to have him on the show. Hello and welcome.
Thank you. Very
great title. Great title. It is so much more than firewood.
We hope.
So how long have you been playing violin?
I've been playing since I'm 7 years old.
Wow. So what was kind of your trajectory? You know, was it a hobby? Is it something that you pursued professionally, or became a filmmaker and wanted to incorporate it?
When I was a teenager, I decided to get really serious about it and started going to a conservatory. I went to a couple of different conservatories, eventually graduated. But after I got out of the conservatory, I didn't feel at home. I didn't feel at home in Western classical music. And I was looking around, and eventually I got into the music of my grandparents, which is klezmer.
Mm, wow. And did you hear it a lot growing up? I mean, was that a influential part of your childhood?
I heard my father playing it on piano. I didn't actually hear klezmer fiddle.
Wow.
Because it's actually a style that disappeared in the 20s and 30s. Anyway, so after I got into klezmer music, it opened my ears up to the rest of the world. It's sort of,
That's so interesting that would be the gateway.
It really was. It's a gateway drug for sure.
A gateway drug that's a legal drug.
And then I took a trip to Morocco, partly because I was excited about what I heard going on in the street there in Marrakesh. Mm-hmm. And I went there, and of course I got sick because I couldn't stand but to drink the fresh orange juice there in the Jam El Fna. And so I went to a nicer hotel, nicer meaning like $20 a night. And they had a little folklore show in the lobby, or in the evening. And I heard Andalusian music, which is the classical music of North Africa, for mm-hmm. the first time. And I was completely floored. And they play, you know, like this.
The lute and like the old.
No, they play a regular violin, the same one I play, exactly the same one I play, but it sounded completely different. And that just blew my mind completely.
So what is that? I mean, it is so interesting. As someone that didn't, I mean, I appreciate music, but it's true. You could hear a violin in so many different styles, and it, like, how does the same piece of wood that's not firewood create so many different sounds?
It's, you can explain it. The violin is this combination of strings and a box and a stick and a bow, right? Mm-hmm. And so the bow, because the bow is not something, you don't pluck the strings, you have a bow, so it's more similar to a human voice.
I see.
And so it's...
You can control it.
One of the reasons it spreads so into so many different styles is that you can mimic all the nuances of language and singing styles. And that's the basis for a lot of folk music.
Wow, it's beautiful. I want to look at a clip and then continue. Yeah. Let's look at a clip.
How could I, a complete outsider, learn to play Irish music like a native?
If you want to play Irish music, you have to squelch the ego and let the soul take over.
The more energy I bring to my fiddle, then the more I muffle my fiddle. And I stop the fiddle from talking to me.
Is it all just technique? Or is it something bigger? Older? Deeper?
The fiddle an Irish instrument?
It is and it isn't. It depends what you do with it. It gives it character. Otherwise, it's just firewood.
So why Ireland?
Well, I actually, in my mind, a long time ago, when I went to Morocco, that's where the seed for this project started. Mm-hmm. And I imagined a whole series of films, each one focusing on a particular style. And I chose Ireland because I was thinking about the American television market. Mm-hmm. And there's 40 million Americans of Irish background. And Irish music is something, it is probably the most popular folk music in the world. Anywhere you go in the world, you can find a hardcore group of people who are playing Irish music in some pub. Almost anywhere, including here in Tel Aviv.
It's true. Wow, fantastic.
And so it seemed like a good starting point.
Right. Well, fantastic. So right now, where can people find, see the movie? It's going to be airing in the States, right?
It's airing in the States right now, especially on St. Patrick's Day, March 17th.
My gosh. Amazing.
It's showing twice. Actually, you have to check your local listings. It's showing on most PBS stations.
Amazing. This is great. So now we're going to take it on the road to a different... So, you're here in Israel, so we can pray to, do a series in many, many countries. Fantastic. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Meanwhile, come